News now from Rajasthan, where the government on Thursday approved 1% reservation for the Gujjar community as well as for other backward castes. And with this initiation, the Gujjars can now seek benefits in educational institutions and job opportunities. Well, let's go across to Harsha now for more on this. And Harsha, this is within that 50% quota that the government has. And is the Gujjar community going to be satisfied with this?
Well, yes, that's really going to be just about touching 50%, Gargi, because this is actually old wine in new bottle. When the first violent Gujjar agitations had happened, this is exactly the formula that had been suggested. Because the Rajasthan government knew that if they cross the 50% mark, it's going to be struck down by the courts. And that's exactly what happened, not only once, but on two occasions that has happened. So finally, with elections now just about a year away in Rajasthan, they've decided the only formula that works is what they offered the Gujjars last time. 1% extra reservation, so they don't cross the 50% mark. And it's not just Gujjars, but all other nomadic tribes like Gadialohars, etc. The Gujjars had also a grouse that last time around, this 1% had been offered to them, but it was not being seen on the ground. They were really not getting educational benefits out of that. So they're hoping around this time around that they will deliver. Twice the Rajasthan government has crossed the 50% mark. They've not only tried to satisfy Gujjars, but other communities as well. And it's been struck down by the High Court. So this, like I said, is really old wine in new bottle. And it's obviously been done with an eye on the elections, which are not very far away now. In Rajasthan, the countdown has begun, just 1 year to go before elections take place here.